Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. You guys are probably wondering, where is this bitch at? We are currently in Washington, D.C. We got here last night around like 8 p.m. So I didn't really get the vlog. The ride was long. I was tired. We went to this place called Stan's that are known for like their wings. And they supposedly have like the strongest drinks ever. And y'all, let me tell y'all, I'll probably insert some clips because listen, they literally basically gave us all tequila and a little bit of a chaser or like juice to put in your drink. So we were definitely lit last night. Right now we're just sitting at our hotel's rooftop. It's so cute. So nice. We have a brunch scheduled today for 12:30. It's unlimited mimosas and food. So I'm excited about that because I don't really know what that means, unlimited food, but it should be good. So we're up here now. So this place is known to have the strongest drinks ever. This is all tequila. And that's the lemonade. Let's go see what Kurt's doing. Okay, my man looks cute. So right now we're walking to find a dispensary. I literally love DC, y'all. Like, the vibe out here is so me, so me. It's kind of like New York, but not as like clutter and just like, or I don't know, maybe the part that I'm in, like, it's just like still giving me city like, but still calm. Everyone's so nice, like so nice. I love going places when everybody's so nice. We're just trying to find, Kurt looked up a dispensary. He's trying to go there. So that's where we're walking to now. So far we've been walking everywhere because our hotel is in like a prime location, so everything is like 10 to 12 minute walk. So, and it hasn't been too hot, cause y'all know I hate being hot. So, but yeah, we're just vibing. We have reservations at 12:30 for brunch. I'm excited. So it's currently like 10:45 right now. So we actually have a lot of time. Kurt, you like DC? It's a vibe. I said it was basically like New York, but way calmer, right? And not as dirty. We love New York though, but DC is definitely more chill. But it still gives you the city vibes. No, they better watch me. So y'all, we finally found a dispensary. Look at the wall, y'all. Fire. We have like an hour to our reservation, so hopefully we're in here quick and fast. So we're just waiting. Unlimited mimosas and food. Let's see how this shit goes. We're at the park. It's so cute. So we have the unlimited mimosa brunch and unlimited food, and I'm gonna show you guys my plate. Y'all know I don't eat bacon, so that's gonna go to Kurt. Our first flavor we wanted to try was strawberry. So anything that you want to try again, because the food, like I mentioned, was unlimited, you just tell them what you want. So I asked for potatoes, more salmon, mac and cheese, and French toast. This is our second mimosa tower. This flavor is pineapple. The first one was strawberry. We're trying so hard to keep eating.
I can't even eat one more, but that salmon is crazy.
Y'all, we're so bent.
She said the mac and cheese, but she ain't even eat that stuff.
Hey guys, I snuck into the bathroom. This place is bomb. I'm gonna try to show you guys the inside because we actually had outdoor seating reserved, which was still cool too. We're like three pitchers of mimosas in, which is Kurt and I, so I'm definitely feeling it. And yeah, I love it here. I love DC. We're getting ready to go back to our rooftop pool just to like relax, because we don't really want to do anything else tomorrow. We have like some museums to check out and stuff like that, so we're just gonna chill till later because we are going out tonight. And yeah. That's because those bottomless mimosas got us, okay? I'm recovering now, about to straighten my hair and do some makeup because we're getting ready to go out, so. Guys, brunch really got crazy. If you guys hear Kurt's music, just ignore it. He's in the room getting ready, and I'm sitting here attempting to try to fix my hair because I'm not really sure what happened. I think I remember I was like sweating, came in, I passed out and didn't really put anything on it. So I'm just going through really quick. I'm not like taking my time to straighten it. I'm just literally taking big chunks. So it could look like something. But no, y'all, that bottomless mimosa got me. Like when I tell y'all we had three pitchers, I'm gonna insert the clip too. So you can see how big it was, but they literally had all different flavors, pineapple, mango, passion fruit, strawberry, I don't even know, like so many different flavors. And the place was $60 per person, so it was $120 for the both of us. Super cute. It's called The Park at 14. It used to be like a club and a gay party. That's originally how we found out about them. Excuse my parents, y'all, I have on pajamas. Because I don't know about y'all, but I don't like getting dressed and then getting ready. Like I like doing my makeup, my hair, and then putting on my clothes, so. Just ignore my attire. But yeah, so the park, they're like low-key known down here. And we've never been for brunch. He's been for like the day party, and I actually never been. So it was really, really good. And how they do it is they basically bring you everything that's on their menu. So we had jerk chicken, eggs, potatoes, French toast, salmon. What else? Am I missing something? Jerk wings, did I say that? I don't know, a whole bunch. And what they do is your first plate is everything. And then whatever you want more of, you just literally keep asking y'all. And when I tell y'all, they just kept bringing us little plates, it was definitely a vibe. Definitely worth $60, especially in three pictures of the mimosas. And by the way, I was thinking they were gonna be like, not strong and like corny. No, they were strong as hell. So shout out to them, they know what they're doing. And we actually sat outside, which I was happy about because I went inside to see, to go to the bathroom, and it was kind of boring inside. I mean, granted, they do have levels, so I'm not sure if the first level was just kind of like corny, but I was very glad we sat outside because it wasn't even hot. Like it's been really good weather here. I haven't been hot at all. Pretty much. So yeah, I'm just straightening my hair, y'all. We took a 3-hour nap, but usually that's what happens when you get drunk early like that. Our brunch was at 12:30. We got there at 12:15. They literally sat at us right away. So our 2 hours has started. Is it straight? Comment down below if this is straight. But yeah, our brunch has started. Was supposed to start at 12:30. We ended up getting there, you know, just early just in case.
And then we had went there actually after we went to the dispensary. That's kind of why we were like, I don't even know why we were rushing looking back, because we had time to do everything we did. But tonight, I think we're about to go to our rooftop bar. Our hotel has a rooftop bar, I don't know if I mentioned that, and it closed at 11. So I think we're about to go up there and just chill, see the vibes, and then we're gonna go to U Street, which is the street that everybody keeps telling us to go to, with a bunch of different hookah lounges, and like, supposedly it's just lit, it's where you wanna be. So, we're getting dressed to do that. I'll probably tap back in when I do my makeup, but let me hurry up. Hey y'all, so, sorry I couldn't do my makeup. I ended up really rushing, but this is the outfit for tonight. I got this little set from Got The Look. It's real comfortable, actually. I'm very excited I'm gonna have this on, because we're going to a spot where it's gonna be a lot of walking and like bar hopping, so I think I look good. So we'll catch you guys there. Hey guys, so we are currently walking to U Street to find a lit hookah lounge and get drunk. We just left the room, we took a couple shots, and yeah, we're lit in U Street. A lot of people outside, everybody's going out, everybody's dressed cute. So yeah, I'll update you guys when we find a lounge. U Street is kind of like a street where it's just like you have so many options. That's why I can't tell y'all where we're going yet, because I don't know. But last time we were here, we went to this Jamaican lounge and it was really cool, but they didn't have hookah, so we probably can't go there again, because we're not looking to eat, we're looking to get like hookah. So I'll update you guys. We have like a 15 minute walk, which is nothing. It's really like three blocks. Oh well, he says yeah. Okay, yeah, we might as well eat too. Oh well, yeah. Okay, yeah, we haven't eaten since the park, y'all, because it took us out, we died. We're back, so I'll update you guys with whatever we do, because I don't know. Bye. So we just got on U Street and it is lit, y'all. I mean, like, hookah lounges everywhere. Clubs, restaurants, hookah lounge, people.
Yeah, you guys, shit.
Everything. It's really lit.
That's your YouTube
guys. Yeah. Hey. So, yeah, this is U Street, y'all. It's really a vibe. Like, honestly, we're just gonna follow these people.
Fuck that dude.
Yeah, y'all, so I told Kurt he has to find me a pizza spot for when I get drunk and need to eat later, and he looked me up this spot. He's so cute. He's not gonna eat it, y'all, but it's for me, because I be wanting pizza when I'm lit. So, but we're on U Street currently. It's a vibe out here, y'all. And you know what else I like? Everybody's black. So everybody's black. Yeah, so it's a vibe. We're still trying to look for like a hookah lounge / restaurant. I'll update you guys on the name of the place we go to when we go to it. So literally so many places to choose from. I don't even know what to do. So we found a place. So actually, y'all, it's crazy. We were just walking down the street and this guy was like, come in, hookah poo, come in. So we were like, all right, bet. We went in, we didn't see anywhere that we liked to like want to sit and like eat some hookah. We went outside, he was like, no, you guys can sit on the rooftop. So we were like, okay, we didn't even know they had a rooftop. Keep in mind, get out to the rooftop, he gives us a whole section, y'all. We didn't even pay for this. Like, we just have a whole section. It's about to be a night, okay? It's about to be a night, because we were in a section and didn't even know about this place. He just really wanted us to stay. Like, that's how desperate he is. So, thank you. Shout out to, where are we at? Amsterdam. Shout out to Amsterdam. It's lit. Like, look, y'all. He really put us in a section on the rooftop. Like, okay. Customer service. Talk about customer service. We're waiting for our hookah. We ordered tequila sunrises because we already started drinking Casamigos in the room. It's good. So yeah, this is what we're on. Oh.
Day and we got lit last night. I don't know if you could tell from the videos, but right now it's like 7:15 and we're walking to the White House. We're going on like a mini tour just early, just because it feels so good out here though. So I'll update you guys if we see anything. I'm trying to see Biden though. I'm trying to see him leave his house, but who knows. I'm not going to say I've never been to the White House, but I don't remember going to the White House or ever seen it in person. I might have rode by as like a little kid, but I really don't remember. So this is gonna be the first time I like stand outside and get to see it up close and personal.
This place is called Barrier.
So yeah, we're just on a morning walk. Only Kurt, like he literally got up at like 6:45 and he was just looking at me and I'm like, what are you doing? And he's like, I'm getting ready to go for a walk. I'm like, okay. So then he goes on a walk. He like left for like literally 6 minutes. He FaceTimed me because he's seen this building we've been talking about, and I was like, oh my god, come back and get me, because like at this point you're clearly going on a tour without me, and I'm gonna be mad if you see some stuff that I wanted to see. So I got my ass right up with him, and now we're just out in these streets. But it actually, honestly, this is probably the best time to go do this type of stuff. Then we're gonna probably go back to our pool. We do have brunch reservations a little later. And then I think we're gonna find a museum and then probably just head home, unless we find something else to do. But we don't wanna leave super early, but we also don't wanna leave super late because we both have work tomorrow. But y'all, DC was a vibe. I literally had the best trip ever, and it's not even over. So I'll check you guys back in. I don't know why, y'all, but I was just thinking the White House looked way bigger. Granted, I mean, they have, it's huge because it probably goes all around, but like this first house, it just thought it would be bigger.
Look at the lawn.
Yeah, they're definitely on standby. Okay, it's cops at every corner. When we were, you guys missed it when I was recording the intro back there, this nice cop, somebody was telling us how it'd be a lot of feds, and yeah, it's crazy down here. But it makes sense though, because I guess the closer you get to the White House, the more, you know, what is it called, security they have. Like they don't play nothing. Like anything that's out of the ordinary, they're on it. So that's why we gotta act normal. Good morning. So we are back and we are at our pool. It's kind of chilly up here, honestly. I don't even know if I'm gonna get in, but we got this little cute little day bed. We're about to just chill here for like literally not long, just for a little until our reservation. We do have to go get dressed and stuff. So beautiful up here. We literally can see the whole city. And you know, I got my Starbucks in the cut. I was so happy we found a Starbucks on the way walking from the White House. So you know me, it's like music to my ears. So I would check back in when I'm dressed and get to the brunch spot, because I just want to relax right now. And I'll show you guys the food, because supposedly their food's good.
Continue straight for 12 minutes, exit 7, I-476 North toward